What's up? It's Hee Haw Jones. You probably already knew that, though. As most of you know, I was in a movie a while ago called Enter the Donkey. And the producers of that movie, they took their own liberties with the footage they had of me and made me look like a fool. I got pretty upset about it and decided I wasn't going to work with them again. But when they decided to do a sequel, they called me begging, saying they couldn't make this movie without me. After some intense negotiations, I decided I was back on board. As with every sequel comes new things, new material, new stuff. I myself, I got some new glasses. Hee Haw Jones 2.0. I'd say probably the thing I'm most excited about is what you're about to see. It's the greatest story ever told. The life and times of Hee Haw Jones.
The movie is not going to be called that, just to be clear.
What? No, that was in the deal.
No, it wasn't. The producers never agreed to that. They're not going to call it that.
No, that was in the contract. Because when we talked to them, I wanted to be the greatest story ever told. And they were like, yeah,
we like that. I was there. There wasn't even a contract.
It was a verbal contract.
No. I'm sure they're not going to call it that. I guarantee.
Screw this. I'm a professional, all right? I don't have to deal with this. You know, what's up? See ya, Jones. You probably already knew that. The producers of the movie said that they'd show my sponsor logos at the bottom of the screen in return for my appearance in this movie, whatever it's going to be called, probably something stupid. So I agreed. And here's my sponsors. Probably a lot more than you're used to, but I'm a pro. So enjoy the movie, and God, get down.
What is that?
Just calm down, okay? It's one of four things, okay? It's either the witnesses, or the Girl Scouts, or the bill collector. All right, just stay calm. They go away.
This breaking news from the banks of the French Broad River. In addition to the already alarming flood warnings for Buncombe and surrounding counties, it is now reported that a major toxic spill originating in Transylvania County is rapidly spreading into watersheds to the east and south, resulting in a rise to these already swollen rivers. The spill is rumored to carry a deadly virus, and initial reports tell of widespread plague-like symptoms. Those affected have been described by some as the walking dead. All citizens are urged to stay in their homes and at all costs to avoid sources of water. This is Rip Tompkins reporting for Channel 25.
Dude, don't you have Evil Dead upstairs? That kind of makes me want to watch Evil Dead right now.
I think we do. Either that or Army of Darkness.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Man,
if it's got rain, let's just check the levels.
I know.
Dude, my golly looks good. Dries might run.
I get a man screamed up.
What the heck is that? See who's out there. Some kind of freak running around?
Nothing there.
You sure?
Yeah.
Man. That's like the last thing you want to hear, like, when you're that news thing.
Ah. Dude. Did you fart?
Actually, I crap my pants. Thank you very much.
Benny.
That is wrong. Gross,
dude, that is rank.
That's rank.
Catnip at the old house box.
songs gone unsung for far too long. If boxing your shadow at the wall full of moss and antlers approach you, then I am at a loss. May you go marching in three measure time, dressed up as asses, drunk to the nines, swing from the rafters, shouting those songs gone unsung for far too long.
Hello, Mom. We're at the Potomac. It's in Washington. No, D.C., not state.
turtle head poking out, man.
National Whitewater Center in Charlotte, North Carolina. I'm stoked to finally be in my first kayaking video. Let's go. Proceed!
5501.
Go on with the chlorophyll.
5051.
You guys need to shut up.
Wow. 5051.
Think of some more, dude. I'm sick of hearing the same two quotes.
I'm really gonna throw this saddle out there.
I will not make out with you, Chris.
Nudie magazine day.
5667.
Proceed.
6104.
Throw the cigarettes.
Hang on. Cigarettes. The sun responds to her mom, I am just not cool. I hear people say I'm freaking dragon to culture. But I think you've been because they're not the words, and actually can be the
Iceman race coming up soon. You see that old boat in the dumpster? I wonder who put that in there. That'd be a good
race right there. Like,
of course, Gus, that's the boat I learned in.
I'm
most daring thing I've ever done is a beef mango Thai salad. How can they say no? That's the best. And, you know, I would have used it in college had I had it then.
Tell me about your new look.
Oh, what, the beard? After, you know, success entered the donkey, you know, my people said, hey, let's make this website, you know? And heehawjones.com, it's all one word, people started looking at that website. And a surprise to me, people can see that website that aren't even boaters. Anybody on the internet can look at heehawjones.com. So people were looking at me like, I like his style, I want his autograph, you know, he's famous, he's a celebrity, you know, like, and people come up to me all the time asking for autographs and stuff. What's happening? I don't do hugs, you know, that's cool, but I don't do hugs. I'll sign your shirt though. Here we go. Here. Easy. What's up with that face? Huh? Is that my brother had that one time? You may want to go get that checked out. Cool. Have a good day. Check it out, heehawjones.com. I put .com after my autograph now, you know, for people to be able to see it. So they know, you know, heehawjones.com, I should probably go there, you know. Anyways, after the success of that, you know, people coming up to me all the time, you know, gas stations and grocery stores saying, I want your autograph. So I grew out the beard, you know, blend in a little bit better. And it all came from coming to this dock. You know, I take the bus here like every day. You know, it's pretty much my dock. I mean, it's a public park, yeah. But I'm here more than everybody else, you know? So it's like my dock. And I just come out here and reflect on being Hee Haw Jones, you know, doing what I do, being a pro. I'd say with the beard though, I'm like a butterfly. I'm metamorphosized, you know? No, I'm like a chameleon. I blend in. You know, people don't recognize me. Or even like, I'm like a combination of the two, you know? I'm like a chameleon fly. Or a buttermelon. I'm like a buttermelon.
We're at the Skookum Chuck Narrows. It's teeming with exotic wildlife. You can see a grand specimen there in front of us. Oh shit. It's not even afraid at all.
It almost killed those guys.
It's on the prowl.
This guy's almost died.
You gotta watch out for those guys obviously are cat whisperers.
go off that right side, sort of cruise down and bounce down that stuff. It'd probably be good.
Hey, Finny, go down to the bottom and like shoot it from the right bank, but like shoot up at me and the rapid, but get me looking, you know, like humble, but powerful, you know? Like, I'll be nodding my head like, yeah, this is my drop.
Uh-huh. Ain't nothing humble about that before.
You ready? Good. All right, get like a, I get up. Dude, look out! No! Look out behind you! Behind you! Finny! Oh my God, Finny! I'm gonna go off that ramp tomorrow, but I'm gonna get dropped in about 800 feet from a space shuttle, and I'm gonna transfer from a parachute to a hang glider midair, and it's gonna be really, really awesome, just cool, and.
There's a lot of young people that are getting really good at kayaking now. What do you think about young people in kayaking?
I don't know if they're getting good, you know. Young people, I think by nature, are incapable of being good at kayaking. They just don't have the maturity that it takes to be good at something. You know, kids today in kayaking have so much potential, and when they flip over and they try a wet exit, all they do is sink, because they're kids. Now, do you want that on your conscience? Do you want to go out on the river and say, hey, kid, you can do that. You go ahead, kid, go out on the river, even though you're an idiot 12-year-old and you got raging hormones, you can't make a decision for yourself, can't even vote. This country says you can't vote, you can't go fight because you're stupid. You're a stupid kid. And you send that kid out on the river amongst pros whose job it is to teach them how to kayak? No. I definitely see myself as a role model. You know, to young people in the sport, yes. But young people in general, even more. I didn't sign up to be a role model. I signed up to be a pro. And that's what I am. And I do a damn good job of it.
What has Hee-Haw Jones done to me that I dislike him for? It's not really anything he's done to me personally, but I really don't like the way he wears his hat. Bugs me. I bet you never thought you'd see me.
Distraction, arrogant amputee. So what's left? I got a head like a train wreck. Cause you can count on the casualties. Fatigue, frost, jack of a fist. Till my ass of a freedom right down. I'm afraid to slow down, I'm afraid to go home. I died enough cause of what I'm not. I can't share what I haven't got. I'm tied enough to what I'm not. And I can't share what I haven't got. Fatigue, frost, jack of a fist. See my ass in the freedom right now. I'm afraid to slow down, I'm afraid to go home. It's gonna catch up to me. It's to the skin knees and sutured hearts. It's to the unhappy endings and all the false starts. It's to the skin knees and sutured hearts. It's to the unhappy endings and all the false starts.
Stop in this town, dude. Joey just got attacked here.
I'm serious. I really gotta go, man.
Dude, why don't you just listen to this cup, dude?
The cup.
Yeah, the cup.
I'm not gonna stop. Go in the cup, dude. I'm serious.
That's fine. I'll just be quick about it, okay?
All right.
Is a tasty snack pack.
Give me a snack pack!
Oh,
the matter, man? You okay? Andy. What's going on? What's wrong with you? Andy. Stop, man.
Nathan, what's up, dude?
Dude, what's up?
Nothing, man. I'm just chilling at my house. What are you doing?
Thinking about going kayaking.
Oh, really? Do some whitewater boat riding?
You want to go to the ledges, man?
Ledges?
The ledges.
Wait,
the sick,
wait, Nathan.
Gnarly, nasty ledges.
Nathan Silsby is going training. Yes, Nathan Silsby. I would love to go to the ledges with you. What time?
I don't know. How does 5 o'clock work?
5 o'clock. 5 o'clock.
I'll see you there.
All right, man. I'll talk to you later, okay?
All right. I love you.
Hey, man. Take care, okay?
All right. Go ahead and hang up. Right. You can hang up.
No, man. You hang up first. I insist.
No. You can hang up.
No. You're so cute. You hang up.
I'm not in the mood for your stupid games.
You're bad. Hang up. Right. You hang up all first.
Right. I'm done with you. I'm done with you.
What?
Hit the ground in a PA town about an early 72. Growed up again. I guess all some things I never knew. God told us I had to hold on to my little bit of self-control. Get my head up, now I'm filled up and I'm taking my
Enjoy your snackers. Slat. Crandy. Hi. Welcome to Harris Teeter. Go, go, go!
Are you serious?
No. Hey, kids. Today I want to talk about strangers. Remember, even if a stranger's wearing a penguin suit, don't just hug them. Make sure they know the special code word that you and your family designate. He might look all cute with sand, ketchup, and spittle on his face, but don't hug a stranger.
What does a 300-pound parakeet say? Chirp! We found the dude. Where's my money, Lebowski? Oh, not the rug, man. I really tied the room together.
You
tooth, man.
No, I was just eating scrambled eggs. It must have been like harder eggs or something.
Yep.
Oh my god. Chris, look.
What is that? Dude, don't do that. You have to call 911 right now, man. Is there somebody under here?
I don't know. You think someone drowned?
Go get your phone, man.
No! It's not another me!
I'm a lumberjack, and I don't care. Work all day and sleep all night.
Kirk, tell me where we're at.
Huh?
Tell me where we're at, what we're doing.
We are.
Tell me why this is the best hole in Colorado.
We're at the Lawson Hole,
and it is the best hole in Colorado because it just makes you feel really good about your paddling skills. Go in there, try your left phonics monkey, and you hit it. Go for the other one, and like, I've never been to another hole that just makes the moves that crisp and nice feeling, and it just makes you really feel like you're a good paddler. It's awesome. It's really deep too, and retentive. It's hard to ask for much more. You can get a lot of left cartwheels there.
What a mess.
Place is a pigsty down here. Come here. Oh. Kelsey. Dude, you alright?
Well, I can't have you standing around in the store or in front of the store with a costume on, so if you want to shout, that's fine.
What about for Halloween?
We don't have Halloween items here, so.
You don't?
No.
Yeah.
So, I mean, what are you promoting?
Oh, I was just penguin, just penguins.
I mean,
just here from like the last migration, and
okay,
that's.
All right, if you're not here for a company and I can't check to see if you're approved or if you're not a shop, then I'm going to have to ask you to leave, please.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah. Well, thanks a lot.
Not a problem, though.
Appreciate the time.
Yes, sir. You have a good day.
Yeah, you too.
What's up, Z-Hot Jones? Bet you thought I was dead. I bet you're wrong. I win all the money in that bet. Because I'm sitting here alive today, while all the other pro kayakers, they got killed off by zombies. You know, but legends never die. I'm living proof of that, you know. I'm number one today, and everybody else is dead. And some would say it's lonely at the top, but, you know, it always has been. So I'm used to it. Am I sad that they're dead? No. It's just less competition for me. Not that there was much in the first place. You know, so pretty much I'm just straight chilling in my house, living the high life. Shit.
to whistle. And give the box three knocks. Should you be so lucky to hear whispering? It is an invitation for you to leap in. May you go marching in three measure time, dressed up as asses, drunk to the nines. Swing from the rafters, shouting those songs, gone unsung for far too long. If boxing your shadow at the wall full of moss, and antlers approach you, then I am at a loss. May you go marching in three measure time, dressed up as asses, drunk to the nines. Swing from the rafters, shouting those songs, gone unsung for far too long.
You guys have fun today?
Fine.
Yeah? See you later. Bye. Do you guys have fun?
Bye.
See you later. Bye.
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 Recently involved in a project called Night of the Living Donkey that was a kayaking movie that claims to be the world's first kayaking horror movie.
Right. Well, and they're wrong.
So they're not the first.
I had the first kayaking horror movie idea ever.
Idea and, or you made a kayaking?
Well, I've got a kayaking horror movie and it's more realistic than theirs. I had the idea years ago in my basement. I've even got mean, I've got drawings from the movie. It's more believable. Because there's, who believes in zombies? Do you believe in zombies?
No.
No, you don't. Do you believe in serial killers?
Yes.
Exactly. And mine had serial killers in it.
So it says zombies, yeah.
Hundreds of serial killers. Yeah. Killing kayakers. And all of them except this was the opening. So you didn't actually shoot the movie.
This is just drawings.
I did. I have plans with the movie to be made. Okay? This is the story, part of the storyboard. It's exclusive. I drew this years ago. This is a kayaker. Right? And like Hollywood people. See, I'm in Hollywood a lot, and some of those Hollywood people don't know what a kayak actually is. They think it's a canoe or a yacht, you know, because they all sail on yachts. And showing how a serial killer would kill the kayakers, you know, coming through the helmet with the knife, because all serial killers kill with knives. That tells all the other kayakers to show up. Or not the kayakers, the other serial killers to show up. And there's like tons of them, and they're crazy, you know. And they're really angry serial killers, because all serial killers have been wronged in their life somehow, you know. So they go crazy, and there's only a couple in this one drawing, but there's gonna be so many of them that they have to come by airplane.
So the serial killers arrive in an airplane.
Yeah, probably. Well, I mean, this is kind of, I mean, in a Hollywood stand, people use symbols, okay? So I'm not saying they have to come in a plane, but I'm saying there's a plane load of serial killers, like 100, okay? And they come to like a competition to kill methodically. Like
how the serial killers
would actually kill the kayakers. They in the back with the knife, just they get in there, and they're crazy, and he's wearing a PFD, you know. Once again, the Hollywood types, they don't know the lingo as much as us in the biz do, but this guy is getting out of the race, you know, and the serial killers, they're all waiting at the end of the race to get these guys, you know. But it was a good thing that I was first place in the race, because I got out first, right? And so I went ahead and I started going back upstream and killing the serial killers with my paddle. You know, I was knocking them out.
So I see you in the picture.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's me. I'm the hero. I'm the pro's pro. So, do I like their movie? Yeah, it's okay. Do I think making a movie about zombies is cool? Or what was your original question? I think it was, what do I think about it? Frankly, I think it's stupid, because it's not believable. You know, whereas mine is something you can, is real,
hundreds
real life.
Of serial killers.
Yeah, I mean, it's realistic, you know, and I think that's what scares people, is that I believe it's real.